When you're building an integration, you may want to take one course of action if a condition is true, and a different course if that condition is false. You can do that with a switch action. In its simplest form, a switch action contains two branches. It tests whether or not a condition is true. It follows one path if it is, and otherwise it follows the second path. That's the same logic as an if-then-else statement that's common to most programming languages. That's the simplest form of a switch action, but a switch action can evaluate more than one condition. In that case, each condition tested will have its own branch with appropriate actions defined. The switch will evaluate the conditions one at a time until it encounters one that's true. Then it'll execute that branch and exit. And if no conditions are true, it'll complete any actions that have been defined on the otherwise branch. When we add a switch from the actions palette, it's initialized with two paths. To define the test condition, we build an XSLT expression that evaluates to a Boolean value. In this example, we'll test to see if the length of the incoming message is less than 5 characters. Then we'll add another branch to the switch, and we'll test to see if the length of the incoming message is exactly 5 characters. And the otherwise branch will be for any message where the length is greater than 5 characters. Now we'll configure the first branch. We'll define the action to take if the message length is less than 5. In our example, we'll use the mapper to update the value of the message. Then we'll define similar mappings for the second branch and for the otherwise branch. We'll activate our integration and test it. First, we'll pass in the word dog. The test window shows the returned message and a record of the integration instance. We see that the switch action correctly routed it to the first branch. In our second test, the word horse is exactly 5 characters long, and it's routed to the second branch. And finally, our third test, the word elephant is more than 5 characters long, so it's routed to the otherwise branch. Our switch action passed the test, and that's good news. Before we go, though, I want to mention one other thing. Lots of programming languages have a switch statement. The specific syntax and behavior vary some from language to language, but what they have in common is that they test a single value and then provide for multiple branches of execution depending on the results of that evaluation. The switch action we just built allows us to test multiple unrelated conditions, each with one path of execution. So in that regard, the logic is really more like an if-then-else-if statement. That's important because if we test unrelated conditions, some value we pass in might qualify on more than one of the tests, but only the first true outcome is going to be routed. So if you define multiple tests in your switch, you want to be sure that only one can be true for each value the switch action processes. Keep that in mind as you define your switch actions, and you'll be able to add conditional routing to your integrations, which is a good thing. And that always evaluates to true.